This one will be the women's 4x100 meters medley relay. A fair amount of support for the Hungarians, who will be in one. Australia, surprisingly, in two, but surely they'll be in the shake-up for the medals. Italy 3, USA 4, Russia 5, Canada 6, Germany 7, Slovakia sneaking in 8th place. You would not bet against Kurzan, Dobler, Hasker and Walsh, would you? Although the Russian quartet's not bad at all. Vashkina, Chikanova, Sabatova, Nikanova. Jane Hanna likely to be leading off in the lead for Canada. Then Avery Wiseman, Hanna, Henderson, Brooklyn, Doothright, Germany with Riedemann from the start. Australia, O'Callaghan, Powell, Ryan and Harris. Looks quite a strong quartet for them. Gaetani, Pilato, Yassi Betty and Tarantino for the Italians. And the home fans will go wild for Zalagi, Bacchese, Athazi and Zoka. Slovakia will be in lane number 8. That's the big cheer, as expected, from the Hungarians. Germany with Riedemann, Heimrath, Claybolt and Vergelmann. Australia, well, they're going to be in the mix. They've got to be, haven't they? Potentially could be winners. Hiding away there, lurking in lane 2. Might suit them. Canada with Hannah Wiseman, Henderson and Doothright. Italy. Gaetani, Pilato again. Problem with Pilato, she's brilliant over 50. She's not really a 100 swimmer. So she'll go like the wind for the first 75 and then be desperate to hang on. Russia, Vashkina, Chikanova, Sabatova, Nikanova, and that's probably the winning quartet you're looking at there. Kurzan, Dobler, Husker, and Walsh. Well, the last event of 6 days of competition here in Budapest. Everything comes down curtain-wise on the action in just over 4 minutes from now. Italy will be trying to make sure they don't do what their men did, get DQ'd. Noise from everywhere, the USA, Australia, Russia, all giving vent to their thoughts and their feelings for their teams, and Hungary, of course, as well. Just wait for it all to subside before the referee can blow the whistle. Starter Viktor Bodrogi on the far side. We'll get them underway. Hungary, Australia, Italy, USA, Russia, Canada, Germany and Slovakia. Australia, courtesy of Molly O'Callaghan, are away very well. USA also in lane number 4. Brilliant start for Claire Kurzan. So it's 2 and 4 right now. Molly O'Callaghan is really going for this in lane number 2, but so too in 5 and 6. Russia and Canada have had decent starts. Expect Jane Hanna probably to be leading. She is at the 50. She is the champion over 100 and 200. The silver medalist over 50, but she is being pushed very hard by Vashkina in the lane beside her. Australia going well. USA back in about 5th place right now. Don't expect that to last for very long. Hanna being passed by Vashkina, so Russia will lead at 100. Russia, Canada, United States crept up to third through Claire Kerzan. How quick was Vashkina? 59.90 for the Russian Federation. Who again will be fancying their chances of maybe causing an upset and doing a double in the medley. Four countries in a line. Italy, USA, Russia, Canada. 3, 4, 5 and 6. And there is nothing really to separate any of them at this stage. 0.21 between Russia, Chikhanova, Dobler in second place. Third, Wiseman for Canada. 4, Pilato for Italy. Where have Australia gone? Back into fourth at the moment. They've got Georgia Powell, then they've got Michaela Ryan, then they've got Meg Harris. Another head-to-head between the USA and Russia. This one probably just going the way of the States in four. Italy doing okay, Russia doing very well, right on the shoulder of the Americans. About a second separating those two. Oh, the changeover's good. Canada's very tight, but good and clean. Italy, so far, fine. Biesibetti in for them, Ryan for Australia, Hathasi for Hungary, Haska for USA, Sabatova for Russia, Henderson for Canada. That world junior record looming there. Canada's 358.38 is what we are talking about. Just a bit ahead of the Americans, but look at the Russians. Look at the Russians now with Sabatova. Another brilliant swim, but I think they're about to get overtaken by Haska. Walsh waiting for the USA. Nikonova for Russia, and then at the moment it's Canada in third place, Italy four, Australia not showing just yet. Tight though, very tight between Russia and the United States. Well, another great finish we're in prospect for here. World junior record looming right on the hands of Gretchen Walsh. Ekaterina Nikonova, I think she might have to take second best. So the big question is not whether America will win, potentially, as to whether, that's a great takeover, by the way, by Gretchen Walsh, whether they can beat that world junior record, which is held by Canada. I think it might be slightly out of range. The gold, however, is not. USA will finish with the gold, Russia with the silver. And who's going to get the bronze? That looks like being Canada. It's pretty clear cut now. That world junior record disappearing out of view. So that's not going to be broken by the USA. That'll stay with Canada. USA, Russia, Canada finishing in third place. Slightly disappointing quartet from the Australians. I thought might push a bit harder, but they didn't. Only team to go sub four is the USA. 3:59.13 for them. Russia just over the four. Canada followed by Italy, Australia, Hungary, Germany, Slovakia. All of the eight teams got their changeovers precise. Some were quite quick, some were quite lackadaisical. USA's 0.12, 0.06. At the back end, 0.19, 0.19 for Italy at the end. Hungary incredibly safe. Australia's very, very safe, but they just couldn't quite ever get the momentum going. But USA take the gold, Russia the silver, and Canada with the bronze. Still three more medal ceremonies, so don't go anywhere, we're not done. We'll be done for another 15 minutes, probably, yeah. And if you are a Kiwi or have any New Zealand affiliations, you better hang around because you're going to see something that we don't see all too often in world swimming. A New Zealand gold medal and the New Zealand anthem to be played here in Budapest. Well, USA were second for quite a bit of that race. They were behind Russia, they were behind Canada for a little while, but when it mattered, they had somebody on the anchor leg who could bring them home and bring them home with style. 53-01, Gretchen Walsh at the end. Tori Husker 57-86, Dobler with a 67-5 on the breaststroke, and Kurzem was not as quick as she wanted to be particularly, nor was Jade Hanna, but she's had a lot of swimming this week. And Russia had a lead off 59-9.